there, fellow travelers. Mark here with Wolters World. Today we're here in Baltimore in the Inner Harbor. And today we have for you are the don'ts of visiting Baltimore. And we got some good ones, we got some interesting ones, we got some ones you need to pay attention to. But I want to start with this, is don't skip out on coming to the Inner Harbor. This is the place, if you're coming to Baltimore, everyone will tell you, you have to go to the Inner Harbor because they've got some really fun stuff you can do when you're here. And the top thing, the number one thing I recommend you do is going right boom there. The National Aquarium, the Baltimore Aquarium, however you want to call it, right there. A fantastic collection of sea life you can go in and enjoy, whether you want to pet the rays or you want to just see the fish going by. I mean, it's a really cool experience. So that's one thing you got to do. The coolest part in the aquarium is this part where you're walking down through the big aquarium and they got the fish going by and the guys are feeding them. So this is the coolest part right here. There's more when you're on the Inner Harbor. Over here, right there, you got the science center. So if you want to get some science in there, you got the kids with you, really fun interactive exhibits. It's a really fun place to be and a really cool place to visit. Also, you can go to the USS Constellation, which is right here. It's a historic ship. You can go and take a tour of that. Also, this is where you get the water tags. If you want to take a little ride around the harbor, you want to go around places, you can take those. And of course, you can always do the little kiddie rides, you know, and go out in the Inner Harbor and ride around there. But it's one of those places you have to really visit when you are here, because people are going to ask, did you go to the Inner Harbor? Okay, this is like the go-to thing in town. So in the city, in the downtown area, now there's a lot of other neighborhoods and stuff, but honestly, if you're going to be coming here, this is the place you're going to be. And what's cool, if you want to have your lump crab cakes, you know, your Maryland crab, all these kind of things, you have good restaurants that are down here too, or famous ones. Now there's great restaurants around town. You can go to Little Italy for some, you can go to other parts of the city, but you know, there's famous ones like Phillips is right there. You can go and get their stuff. If you want to go up to the Lexington Market, you can walk up there and take an Uber up there and go get some stuff there. You can have that. So you do have options. But I will say this, don't think all the restaurants and all the sites and shops here at the Inner Harbor are really the best of the best of Baltimore, because there's stuff spread out throughout the city. So here it's more of a touristy kind of area. And so with that, the prices and the options are kind of less Marylandy, I'd say, you know, so do be aware of that. So if you're looking for a good restaurant, maybe look up online and have some other ideas and take an Uber out to go see something when you're here, okay? Because it is really fun. And I'm actually here, and my buddy Rob's actually visiting from DC, so I'm gonna go to him and he's gonna give you some of his don'ts of being somebody that comes to Baltimore quite often. So now I'm here with my buddy Rob from TripX DC. And so, hey, Rob, tell, well, So now I'm here with Rob from TripX DC. We're actually right outside of Camden Yards where the Orioles play. And Rob, what are some don'ts you have for people when they come here to Baltimore?
Well, I'm from Washington, D.C., and my first don't is don't sleep on a day trip from Washington, D.C. Now, I personally don't recommend very many day trips, but this is one of the few that I do recommend. And the reason is because it's not far away. It's only about a one-hour train ride. You can come in the morning and you can go back in the evening, and it's a big enough city that there's plenty to do, but it's not such a huge city like New York or Philadelphia that you're going to be overwhelmed with too much to do. So I think it's a pretty good day trip if you're staying in DC for a week or so and want to try something a little bit different. Come up here to Baltimore.
Or if your friend's here, you can come and visit them for the day, like Rob's doing with me too. So we have that. So what are some other ones here? I'll make this so I'm not holding a selfie stick so that you can talk to them and we'll get a nice better view of Rob.
If you like baseball, don't skip a chance to go see a game at Camden Yards. You don't have to be an Orioles fan. If you like baseball, if you like ballparks, Camden Yards, it's a classic. It's one of the best ballparks in the major leagues. I've been to quite a few and I can say this one is legit. So if you like baseball, come catch a game here at Camden Yards. Don't think that Washington, D.C. is the only place to go if you like history. If you're a history buff like me, you've got to come to Baltimore, go to Fort McHenry, go to the Flag House, see the spot where the actual Star Spangled Banner flew over Fort McHenry during the War of 1812, when the British were dangerously close to taking this country back. But we've won, and Fort McHenry, great place for a history buff, and the Flag House to see where it was made.
Now, anybody coming to Baltimore knows there is one specific seasoning they love here. And I think, Rob, I think you should take this, don't.
Old Bay seasoning. If you come to Baltimore, don't skip out on getting Old Bay seasoning on your food.
Yeah, like everywhere. Seriously, Old Bay, they have a problem here. This is Old Bay hot sauce on wings, okay? They love the Old Bay. Love it. Like, of course, with the crab. But someone told me about a Baltimore margarita.
Oh, yeah.
Where they put Old Bay on the rim of the glass and the beer.
Yeah. I mean, Bloody Mary, you can get it in a Bloody Mary. You can get it on popcorn. You can get it on French fries. You can get it in a beer. There's plenty of breweries here in Baltimore that'll put Old Bay seasoning in the beer. So don't just think it's for the crabs and the crab cakes. You can get Old Bay seasoning on literally everything, and people here will order it on literally everything.
Literally, and you can't make fun of either. Don't make fun of the Old Bay either, because it can be dangerous, okay, if you do, because it's such a thing here. So, Rob, tell them where they can find you. So if you're going to be in D.C., I recommend TripXDC. His guided tours are fantastic. We do it every time. He's my friend, and I hire him. That's how good he is, okay? But, Rob, where can they find you?
Thanks, Mark. TripXDC.com if you want to check out the TripXDC podcast, learn about TripXDC guided tours. Mark has been a guest on a few of those TripXDC podcast episodes, and the TripXDC YouTube channel, which I'm sure Mark will be generous enough to link to in the description of this video.
Oh, yeah. If you go down below, it'll be there, and also at the end of the video, we'll have it there, and we'll have one of Rob's review some of the don'ts of Washington, D.C., because he helped me with that one, too. So, Rob, thanks, buddy.
Thank you.
And we're going to get back to
Baltimore.
Thank you, and we'll see you guys on our next don't somewhere else in town. Now, my next don't for you when you're here in Baltimore has to do with the food, and that is don't pass up Maryland blue crab. I mean, Maryland has fantastic crab in all the different ways you can have it, but honestly, it tastes wonderful here. I think it's because how the water comes in, like the fresh water that comes in with the brackish water, and it's just everything that's there. I mean, it just makes a sweeter crab meat, and you'll notice the difference whether you're having, you know, lump crab cake, so you're having crab in your mac and cheese, or you're having, oh, Maryland crab soup. Oh my God, it is so good. It's not like a cream bisque. It's a whole different thing. And yes, you probably find some crab bisque too, but there's so many things that have crab in it. You know, Chesapeake chicken, where it's like chicken with crab meat on top. Oh my God, do not pass up getting Maryland crab when you're here, because it is so good. And honestly, there's tons of really good seafood when you're here. There's a bunch of oyster houses you can go to. I mean, oh my God, you can't go wrong. I mean, I've got a whole video on food of Maryland and Baltimore. You can watch that, but honestly, oh, just the crab meat here is unbelievable. So don't miss out on that. Another Maryland staple you definitely don't want to miss out on, because you'll have no choice but to eat it, is Old Bay seasoning. Now, if you haven't had Old Bay seasoning, I always feel like it's more of a seafood seasoning kind of thing. I know we use it when we do like low country boils in Savannah, but it's a specific spice. And they love it here. Like, they love it so much, you can get t-shirts of it when you are here. And the thing is, I mean, there's ones that literally say, like, I like Old Bay on my Old Bay. And they put it on everything. When I mean everything, it's not just in the crab, or on the crab, and it's not just, you know, in the crab cakes. I had a oyster shooter. So it was Natty Bow, and then they put an oyster in it, and they rimmed the glass with Old Bay and had that. I mean, popcorn with Old Bay. I mean, they love that stuff here, okay? So don't think you're gonna get away from it. I mean, I had chicken wings the other night, and it was an Old Bay hot sauce, okay? So that's one thing you're really gonna have to have when you're here, and it's kind of a strange obsession, so just be aware of that. And I mentioned Natty Bow, and I gotta tell you this. If you're an adult, you're over 21, don't pass up having the local Baltimore beer, a Natty Bow. If you're not sure Natty Bow, it's National Bohemian. It's a local beer brand. It's owned by past Blue Ribbon people. They brew it, but that is definitely a beer that's here. It's such a beer that if an Orioles game is going on, you'll actually see orange cans of it, okay? But Natty Bow is just one of those beers you might want to have when you're here, because it is truly a Baltimore beer. And honestly, there's probably a reason why it only sells in Baltimore. But they love it. They love it here. And the thing is, the Natty Bow, the Maryland crab, I think another don't I have for you is don't doubt Baltimore's pride about Baltimore. Like, you will see more people wearing their Orioles jerseys, their Ravens gear. I mean, they don't even like the owner of the Orioles, but they just love their team and the Ravens. They love the Ravens, and they really are really proud of their city. Even though Baltimore gets a lot of grief out there and a lot of people talk bad about it, the people have like a really big, hey, we're from Baltimore, you know, we're Charm City, you know, let's go. I mean, it's a definite different vibe that you have when you're here about how they feel about their city, even with its issues, okay? So that's one thing I would say is don't mess with their pride when it's here. And honestly, like Rob was saying, going to a game, if you can go to, you know, an Orioles game during season, or, you know, when the Ravens are playing, go to a game, because honestly, the downtown area changes when it's a game day, okay? So that's one of the cool things when you're here. And the thing is, when you're coming here, if you're not gonna come for sports, you don't wanna go to the Inner Harbor and just like do the boat tours and stuff, another thing I gotta tell you is, don't miss out on the tons of really great museums that are here. Yes, I talked about the National Aquarium. I've talked about the Maryland Science Center. You got the Museum of Industry. You've got the Wolters Art Museum. No relation to me. They spell it differently. They have that. There's the Baltimore Museum of Art. I mean, there's just so many museums out here. The B&O Railroad Museum, you can go to that. Yeah, if you got your kids, the Port Discovery Children's Museum. You can see the historic ships of Baltimore. You can go and check those out when you are here. Remember the USS Constellation? We talked about that. The American Visionary Art Museum, some other fun stuff. I mean, there's a lot of really great museums on the art side, but also the history side. Learn about African American history in the US and just other parts in the history of Baltimore in this area. I mean, like Rob was saying, Fort McHenry, going out there to learn about the history of the national anthem and the fort that's there. I mean, it's one of these towns that has a lot of stuff you can do and see if you want to do the culture side of things, but also you want to do the sports side of things. You can do some of those too. So that's one of the things that's really nice. And don't forget to pay respects to Edgar Allan Poe, probably the most famous, you know, Baltimore liver here at one timer out there. I mean, the Ravens, the football team here, is named after one of his stories, okay, one of his poems. And you'll see some Poe stuff here. And they actually have the Edgar Allan Poe House and Museum you can go to and take a visit there. So there's a lot of stuff you can see and do here culturally, fun-wise, food-wise, is all that seafood and especially that crab. Oh, and maybe I did have a bit too much Old Bay when I was here, because I really did buy a t-shirt with Old Bay on it. But honestly, it's been a fun time when we've been here. Now, if you're looking for neighborhoods, don't forget to come to Fells Point. This is probably your best neighborhood to go out to eat, drink, and make merry at night and be in a safe environment. This is probably the best one to go to. I've actually had multiple Uber drivers and taxi drivers and locals tell me, Mark, you should go out here to eat at night. You should go out here and drink at night. This is your place to be. And actually, the food here I've had has been fantastic. I was just at the Thames Oyster House. Their you know, clam soup was fantastic. I mean, you've got great places around here and bars. Nice neighborhood too, with really good architecture, so you do have that. You go to Mount Vernon, where the Wolters, the Wolters Art Museum, though they spell it wrong, you can check out there. But there's a lot of neighborhoods. Now, speaking of other neighborhoods, don't miss out on the Mount Vernon neighborhood, because, well, you've got the Methodist Church over there, which is fantastic. You got the George Washington Monument here. But for me, yeah, don't miss Fells Point. This is the one you really want to go to, especially for some good food. Another thing for Baltimore is, don't think you have to drive everywhere and you got to take an Uber all over the place. I'm going to say this, don't pass up taking the water taxi. Now, don't think it's every day, because it's not every day. Weekends, Saturdays, Sundays, you're for sure going to get it. But it's cool because they have multiple loops. You can do the downtown loop, go from here at the Inner Harbor, go out to Fells Point, which is a really cool neighborhood, like I'm sure I'm talking about in this video somewhere. But you can do that. It does multiple stops along the way. So you can get the East Harbor, you can go to, you know, Federal Hill over there. You got all kinds of stuff that you can stop at. But it's a really nice way to kind of take in the harbor, take in the port, yeah, the port feel. You know, because Baltimore has got a history of water, history of being a harbor, and important. That's one of the things you can easy do. And the thing is, if you're getting your tickets, I mean, it's like $18 one way and $20 for the whole day. Just do the whole day one, because then you can hop on and go see stuff. Then you have to walk around. I mean, heck, even going from here to the other part of the harbor, really, it can save you some time. So don't pass up the taxi or the water taxi. The guys on there are really nice too, so it's like a double win. So don't pass it up. Bye, guys. Now, I know maybe Rob alluded to that before when he was talking about the day trip from DC to come here, but honestly, I think a big don't for coming to Baltimore is, don't think you're going to be paying DC prices. Whether it's hotels, going out to eat, entertainment, it is cheaper to do stuff here in Baltimore than it is in DC. And actually, there's people that actually live in Baltimore because it's so much cheaper, and then commute into DC for work because I need to save some cash. So if you're a tourist, that could be an option. It is a way, so, you know, you gotta take the train in if you want to drive in, so might negate the savings for using this as your base. However, I'm just saying, in terms of a budget aspect, this is, you know, don't think DC prices, think a little bit less, and you'll be a little bit better, at least in your budget. That's cool. Rob came and visited me from New York on the train. Very easy to get here on the train. Connections are very nice. You can get up to New York City, get down to DC. I mean, Philly's close. I mean, you can get a lot of places. And if you're going to be flying in, I do have some don'ts for that. One, don't forget there's actually multiple airports you can fly into, because BWI is the Baltimore Washington International Airport. You can fly into there. You can have that. But also, you could use the DC airports because they're so close. So if the prices are super different, you might want to check those prices as well. But honestly, flying into BWI is super easy if you're coming into Baltimore, because it's so close. I mean, it's like a 15-minute drive from the airport to here in the Inner Harbor. I'm like, literally, you leave the airport, all of a sudden, I'm like, wait, that's the Ravens Stadium. There's Camden Yards, the Orioles. Oh, there's Inner Harbor. I mean, it's like boom, boom, boom. Super quick to get in. Like, seriously, it was 15 minutes. So that might be one thing you might want to consider is, oh, if I'm going to come in from DC, it's going to take a lot longer. Am I really saving the money? Is it worth it? That might be something I would look into. A don't at the airport I have for you is don't think they make it easy to find a taxi or your ride share when you're at BWI. Look, I had asked multiple times. They actually did have like little printed out signs saying, oh, go this way for your ride shares. Just so you know, if you're going to pick up your Uber or Lyft, at least when I've been here, you had to go to the upper level, so like the departure level. You had to go there and go out the doors there. The Uber and Lyft apps would tell you where to go, so that was helpful. But yeah, they made it really complicated. Like, I was just going to try to grab a taxi, but I couldn't figure out where the taxis were. So that can be a little bit complicated, so just be aware of it. So if you're going to be coming in, you have that. Because if you don't want to take a ride share or a taxi, they do have a light rail that'll bring you into town. But honestly, if you've got luggage, I would say don't do that. Take a ride share or a taxi in to get you into town, because it's so close, so easy, you can't go wrong. Now, another don't I have for you when you come here to Baltimore is, look, don't think the locals pronounce Maryland, Maryland, or Baltimore, Baltimore. Maryland is more Merlin, okay? And Baltimore is more Balmer, okay? So be aware of that, because I know sometimes you're like, wait, are they talking about like the round table? No, they're talking about Merlin, Maryland, all right? So don't get confused with that. And same thing with Baltimore, because I have seen some people go, what'd they say? So just so you know, all right? So remember, Merlin, Maryland, okay? And then Baltimore's Balmer, okay? Now, a don't I do have to bring up when you come to Baltimore is don't play around with your safety. Yes, I know these sirens are going off in the background, but whether you're in the Inner Harbor, you're going to Little Italy, you're going around the city, you know, if you're heading over to the power plant, you're going to different things, you do need to pay attention. If you're going to go to Lexington Market, pay attention when you're around, because there is issues here in Baltimore. I'm not going to say this is the safest city in the country. It's not. You will have times where you feel uncomfortable, and that's what I want to tell you is, don't take your safety for granted when you're going around. Use an Uber to go places. Get a taxi to go places so you have that. Don't be wearing your bling and your fancy stuff out there. Pay attention when you're going out at night, you know? And that's why I say it's really important to talk to your hotel, talk to your concierge, ask them, hey, where should I go? Where should I go? Yeah, where should I go? Where shouldn't I go? These kind of things, because it's important to know anywhere you go. But here in Baltimore, you do need to pay attention to your safety a bit more, so do be aware of that. Some districts you're gonna be fine, but other parts you might wanna have a heads up. So just wanted to give you a kind of a heads up on that one when you're here. So I hope that helped you learn a bit more about coming to Baltimore. If you wanna learn more, maybe the eats of coming to Baltimore in Maryland, we've got a video on that on our Wolters World Eats channel. We also have videos for cities and states all around the US, also videos of cities and countries around the world. So check us out on our Wolters World website. And also, if you do hit that subscribe button, we put out new videos every Wednesday and Saturday. And we wish you all the best and have a great time here in Baltimore.